Today, I'm joined again by Waleed Abdulla, founder of Ninua. Thanks for coming in today, Waleed.
Thank you, Martin.
So for viewers who didn't watch previous episodes, would you give a brief description of what Ninua, your startup, does?
Sure. So we have two products, Symphony at symphonytools.com. It's a social media management dashboard for businesses to publish their content to multiple social networks and to listen to what their customers say about them on these social networks. And the second product is Networked Blogs, which is a platform for bloggers to promote their blogs and interact and network with their readers and other bloggers, and has about 1.2 million blogs on it.
Great. So Waleed, in previous episodes we talked about business challenges, and for this one, let's talk about technology, a topic that's very near and dear to my heart. I'm an engineer from the beginning. You too?
Yep.
All right, great. So tell us a bit about your first technology platform that your app was built on.
Sure. So Networked Blogs started in a hackathon, and for me it was a side project to learn about the Facebook platform at the time, and most of the examples were written in PHP and MySQL, so I thought, okay, I'll just build it with that. It wasn't planned to be a long-term project, and then it ended up being a long-term project, so but that's how we started, so PHP, MySQL.
Great. And how was the traction of the platform? How many users did you get?
It started growing pretty fast from the beginning, and at some point we were adding about 1,000 new bloggers every day.
Wow.
We have about 1.2 million bloggers and about 7 million users on it. So yeah, it over time it grew much bigger than I anticipated.
That's great.
Yep.
Good problem to have. So what happened with the technology platform with these additional users?
It didn't scale very well. In the beginning it was great, but over time the server was kind of at capacity, and then so we added another server and then a third server, and it wasn't that stable. I was learning how to scale a product as I get as I kind of work on it. It would crash occasionally. It would crash in the worst times possible, like middle of the night or when I'm out watching a movie with friends, and I would have to drop whatever I'm doing and just fix it.
Won't be invited to movie night again with those friends.
Yeah. It was a kind of running joke about,
So what did you do? You can't have your product going down or you're having to wake up in the middle of the night all the time.
Yeah, that wasn't fun. So. I tried to scale it on PHP and MySQL for a long time, and it kind of worked, but it was a lot of work and was a lot of time spent on the scaling as opposed to like improving the product. So at some point, I decided that I'm going to move it to Google App Engine. I had experimented with Google App Engine before that on other small kind of side projects, and it worked really well. So I kind of just made the decision to actually move it, and then. It took a while to actually move, but once we did that, that solved all the scaling problems.
Mm. It sounds very easy when you're saying it now and after the fact, but this must have been a very big decision for you.
Yeah.
Were you concerned about being locked in?
So that definitely was one of the concerns. One of the experiments I did at the time was to kind of test the theory of how would it work if I wanted to move out of App Engine? Like, am I really stuck? So there were a couple open source products. One was called Typhoon AE, and the other was AppScale, that allows you to take your App Engine app and run it without modifying the code. You can run it on Ubuntu, for example. Hmm. So at the time, I used Typhoon AE and ran this experiment to see if I can take the app and run it on Ubuntu. And in one day, we managed to do that. And we had an application that was working fairly okay. It wasn't production ready, but it was like working. You can interact with it and navigate and register, and you know. So that gave me a good confidence that okay, if the need happens in the future to move out, it is possible to take the same source code and run it on a different platform with that lot of modifications. It might take more than a day, obviously, probably maybe a week, maybe even a month, but it would still, at least it's possible. So that gave me this comfort to say, yep, I can take this risk.
I see. So then did you end up porting the system to App Engine and decide on a particular D-day and switch everything over?
No, so the app was fairly big, a lot of pages, a lot of features. We had a lot of traffic. Our database was really big. And it wasn't practical to just kind of rewrite everything and then just switch over in one evening. So what we did was more of a piecemeal approach. So we'll take one page, migrate it, and after a while, we'll take another. Whenever we have to update a certain feature or kind of make a big change to it, we'll take the opportunity to rewrite it as well in Python, and we moved it to App Engine. So we did it one step at a time.
Hmm. So I guess that approach meant that you could do it safely and at your own pace.
Right.
But it also must have led to complexities of having the system now living in two places and the data living in two places. Or how did you do that?
Exactly, yeah. So there were tables that were, like database tables that were not changing often. So we simply just have two copies of them on both platforms. For other tables that change a lot, we would replicate them. Or we would have one master table and all the data is there. So for example, where we store the articles, we just put that on App Engine. And then whenever a page that's on PHP needs to access that data, we created an API that simulates the MySQL interface. So in your PHP, when you call MySQL and you get records back, what this does is kind of takes the request, sends it to App Engine, gets the data, and then formats it in the same format that MySQL returns. Mm-hmm. So the code runs and as if it's actually pulling the data from MySQL, but actually it was pulling it across the internet from App Engine. And it was fast enough, and we managed to do that, kind of migrate slowly by doing this kind of abstracting the data layer.
Great. All right. So now that you moved everything over to App Engine, what were the costs now that you had the full, millions of users and mm-hmm. huge changing database? How did the cost work out?
So I think the cost was a little bit higher. It's hard to tell exactly because we were also growing and we had more traffic, so it's hard to tell. But my sense is that it is a little bit higher, but at the same time, I save so much time and I sleep better. And just the amount of time that I used to spend on having to deal with like memory issues and scaling and CPU, you know, whatever, all the scaling related issues are all gone. So I just focus on actually building code and releasing new features, and that's very valuable.
Thank you for sharing your experiences with us, Waleed. And good to hear that you can go and watch movies with friends nowadays.
Thank you.
That's it for today. I hope you found this, what we were talking about today, useful for your startup. If you have comments, please log them under the YouTube comments section. We love to get comments and we read everything you write. Finally, if you are in a startup, please go to developers.google.com/startups. to find out how Google can help your startup. That's it. See you next time.